Caretakers of a home that belonged to King Kamehameha III say the historic site is not getting the respect it deserves. The area is off limits to the public, but the caretakers say that's not stopping people from using the site as their own playground. Brent Romadna joins us with more. Brent?
Joe, a viewer used the reported feature on our website to send us a photo of a group of people climbing all over the ancient walls at Kaneakapupu. And the site's caretakers tell me that's not even the worst of it. It's a historic place.
Wanoa, the couples are lifted, you are welcome to come.
And a place many consider sacred. But there's a problem.
People climb the walls, and as you can see, the walls are not structurally sound, and they're knocking this place down.
These aren't just ordinary walls, and the place they're knocking down is Kaneakapupu, the summer palace of King Kamehameha III. And as you can see, this is a very old structure.
So it's important politically, it's important in terms of religion.
Baron Ching is the vice president of Ahahui Malama o Kaneakapupu, the group that takes care of the site. He says people not only come to see the structure, but some people are leaving graffiti, moving pieces of the structure, and that's not all.
Someone is doing topless photography up here. Topless.
Kaneakapupu is a closed site and is not open to the public. But like many sites here in Hawaii that are off limits, websites are still promoting them and people are showing up. Have you reached out to any of these sites that do promote the place?
Yeah, like I said, I've actually went to these sites and, you know, the comments that follow, I said, you know, no, you're not free to do this kind of stuff. No, you can't come up here. This is watershed. You're not allowed up here.
Signs have been posted by the group telling people to keep out, but
somebody stole the sign.
Ching's biggest concern, though, is the people who visit and don't show respect to this historic piece of Hawaii's past.
Some people hold it sacred, some people don't. But you can't just go out there and desecrate the darn thing.
And after reaching out to the Department of Land and Natural Resources, I learned that anyone who knowingly takes, destroys, or alters any historic property is liable for civil and administrative penalties. You can also be fined between $500 to $10,000 for each violation. Brent Romadne, KHON 2 News.